Welcome, Del.
Well, nice to be here. Australians, how are you?
They're from everywhere today. You've got them from almost every state here. Plus, of course, we're going all around the country. This is 12th or 13th tour of Australia?
I think it's the 13th. Nobody's... Last time I was here, I think they said the 12th.
You're not superstitious?
Like the guy said, they're a little hard drinking there 10, 12 years ago. I don't know, it could have been four tours or none. I don't remember.
I remember, in fact, your first tour in 61 with Chubby Checker. I remember going to the stadium for that wild rock and roll night. What do you remember of that, the first trip?
Oh, I remember that. It was Bobby Rydell, right? Mm-hmm. And Chubby. And, I remember the kids used to come up on the stage and these bodyguard people would throw them off, right? And it was a tall stage. What was it called? The Sydney Stadium. Sydney Stadium, yep. Yeah, which is now a railroad station. Is that right?
Basically, tennis courts and a road.
Tennis court, yeah, well. But it was great working there. I remember that, yeah.
Well, you look back on that now. Obviously, things have changed despite your successes. I mean, was that a real heavy thing for a young kid out of America?
To come here?
To get that sort of adulation, to get that sort of the rock and roll crowds.
I mean, I was picking strawberries in a field, you know, as a kid, thinking, someday I'm going to be in the movies, you know, and they all laughed at me, and of course I did make a movie. It was a horrible movie. So.
What was the movie? I don't remember that.
Oh, it was called It's Tradad.
It's Tradad.
Yeah, it was really, it was a pretty big hit in England, I think. But it was very scary at first, you know, that's what you really want, and then when you get there, you think, wow, is this it? I had the first show I did was in Broadway at New York City from a rock-throwing, knife-throwing, this is really true, throwing knives at each other and throwing bottles and fighting, and it was really rock and roll, sort of rock and roll, just coming in. And from taking me from this club where they used to fight and take me to New York, put me on Broadway, I mean, it was amazing. And then I thought, well, I'm going to Broadway. I had this great dressing room, and man, the dressing room was Dion, myself, and Bobby V in this little room. I mean, it was like, and the window wouldn't close, and the wind came in, it was cold, it was about March, I think it was. So I kept sometimes wishing I was back in the strawberry patch.
Yeah.
Because it was so scary, you know.
But not for long. Now, whatever happened to Chubby Checker? He married a Miss America. And then
Chubby's doing great. I mean, Chubby is the road man of all time. I mean, he lives on the road. He has.
So he's still singing and entertaining?
Oh, Chubby just had a hit with the Fat Boys. It was called The Twist. They redid The Twist, and he had top 10 record. And Chubby's works, I think, more than any artist that I know. He even works more than Willie Nelson. So, and he's on a bus, and he loves his bus.
Everything that I read about you, when you look back at your almost, well, certainly 2 decades plus in the business, refers to you as being ahead of your time in the fact that you were a singer who sang your own songs, who wrote your own songs, the fact that some of the arrangements, the production and so on, that Musitron as well was
signed.
Geoff, can you just play that again? That's what we're talking about, the sound which was so distinctively Del? That was you, wasn't it? Where did that come from?
Well, Max Crook, his father, we were kids, right? And the drummer said, I know a great organist. My guitar player quit, and I said, oh, I don't know, I need a guitar player. And he said, oh, this guy's amazing, he has this little box. And it sounded just like Geoff was playing there, but it was a little box like this, and he had a camouflage, so no one would know what it was. And he put it through this amp, and when I auditioned him, you know, I started singing, and he put the strings behind me and everything. I said, wow, this guy's hired immediately. And because he could make bassoons and basses and all kinds of great sounds. So the one night I wrote Runaway, I called Max the next day and I said, Max, I need an instrumental. When I point to you, play something. And he played that solo. It just came out right out. In 2 days, we wrote that.
It seems to pitch with your voice, though. I mean, like Roy Orbison, you have this... the ability to get up on a real high.
I can get up fairly high still, you know.
Yeah. Well, what about the... Can you... again, I was thinking in terms of you're regarded as the inspiration for the Beach Boys. You helped actually ease the Beatles into America on their particular tour. The Mersey Beach sound was pretty much allegedly following your Little Runaway.
Little Town Flirt, I think, was kind of...
Yeah.
See, I've always...
Can you play a bit of that for us?
Oh,
Little
sure.
Town Flirt?
I get my inspiration on the guitar.
Do you remember Little Town Flirt?
Yeah.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, Little Town Flirt. You see, Little Town Flirt was like taken from guitars in Nashville. You go like the, you notice in the record, it goes. That's one guitar, and then my guitar goes. That's all it is. So it's just got that kind of roll and rhythm, you know, that's been around for years, but...
And yet it became the Mersey bit, I mean, that people started...
Maybe. You know, I don't take any credit, you know, if they give it to me, I'll take it, you know, I take anything they give me. But it was, you know, here she comes, little town folk, falling for her, but you're gonna get her. Yeah, I know it's so hard to resist the temptation of her tender red lips, but you can get her, her, her. Yeah, you can get her, her, her. Fooling around, fooling around with that little town flirt.
Good sound, isn't it? Good sound.
Well, you got it there, don't leave it.
Yeah.
You mentioned how the voice can go up. Again, you were the first of, I guess, of the rock and rollers to introduce yodeling with Swiss Maid. Was that?
Yodeling came from Roy Rogers, and he was also a jumping cowboy back in America. I forget. Kenny jumping cowboy somebody. And he used to yodel, 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 yodel. And then when I was a kid, I would yodel like. And then Hank Williams came on with, "She's long gone and now I'm lonesome blues." So then I went to Nashville and I met a guy named Roger Miller down there, who was as crazy as a lunatic.
It still is.
And he had this song called "One Time a Long Time Ago." And I said, "That's a great song." And he said, "Well, if you like that, you'll like this even better. It's not finished yet." So he played me this other great song. And so he said, "Meet me in the morning, we'll have it finished." So Roger Miller. So I go to the office in Nashville, Tennessee. No one was cutting much in Nashville. So I said, "Well, we're waiting, and Roger isn't here." And he says, Roger's in Los Angeles. He left about midnight last night." I said, "You're kidding. What about the song?" So forget it, you know. So we were stuck with the Swiss Maid, which wasn't a bad deal to be stuck with.
No.
And when I saw Roger later on, I said, "Roger, whatever happened to that song you were finishing?" He says, "What song?" I said, "He didn't even remember."
Give us a bit of the yodel for Swiss Maid.
I'll do the end, because that's the only place you... Yolala! End, yeah.
Well, I don't attack the voice too much, but I read, just quickly, I read that back in 1974 when you came to Australia, you said, "I don't know what I'm going to be doing when I'm 50. Well, I don't want to be rude, but you're getting close to that, and here
getting
you are,
close.
Rock and rolling again.
Well, see, I still don't know what I'm going to do when I'm 50.
But you're on the right track, aren't you?
I hope so, yeah.
All right, terrific. Del's going to come back and sing for us, but Del Shannon's crime story tour. This weekend begins at Seagulls up the coast, March the 4th in Castle Hill RSL, March the 8th, Sawtell RSL in Coffs Harbour, March the 10th, Reevesby Workers Club, and March the 11th at Rudy Hill RSL. Now, one of those I'm going to catch when...
After that, I'm going to go home, man.
Sounds like a lot of work for a man, isn't it? Can you play us to break on maybe the new song that you've got?
Well, I'll play a little bit of it.
Anything you like, play us to break.
Aim, it doesn't matter. She went away with another guy, and I won't even look at her. Hats off to Larry, he broke your heart, just like you broke mine when you said we must part. You told me lies, now it's your turn to cry, cry, cry. Now that Larry said goodbye to you, sound strange. I want you back. I think you change. But there's one more thing I gotta say. Hats off to Larry. He broke your heart, just like you broke mine when you said we must part. You told me lies. Now it's your turn. You broke mine when you said we must part. You told a million lies. Now it's your turn to cry, cry, cry. Now that they ever said goodbye to you. To you. Hats off to Larry. He broke your heart just like you broke mine when you said we must part. You told me lies. Now it's your turn.
Great guys. Now listen, Geoff's prepared to go on tour with you. He likes rock and roll so much he'll go on tour with you.
He's got it. He plays great, you know.
He's great, isn't he?
The whole band. Let's have a hand for the band.
Yeah.
Rock and roll band.
And we didn't mention North Sydney. You're coming back to North Sydney as well, so we'll try
that's
and
right,
catch.
Yeah.
I'll certainly go and catch you then, and we might get you back on the show.
That's one of my favorites, North Sydney.
All right, we'll get you back here.